We all know that the US government loves their drones. We love to send these unmanned drones to other countries where we can kill as many people as we want from the comfort of our own offices, right? You just sit there, you control it from miles away, sometimes hundreds of miles away. It doesn't matter. You don't have to put your life at risk. You don't have to risk your soldiers, but you still get to kill people. That is the beauty of these drones for the US military and the federal government. And Trump loves these drones so much that he has decided to actually unilaterally alter a 1987 missile agreement that the United States entered into with 35 countries so that we can finally export these kick-ass drones all over the planet. Isn't that wonderful? Now, here's the thing. You actually can't just alter an international treaty. That's something that actually every signatory would have to agree to. So Trump is effectively breaking the treaty because he doesn't have the authority to just unilaterally change it. The treaty, by the way, is the 1987 Missile Technology Control Regime. 35 countries have signed on to it. And basically what it says is you can't export or sell these large missiles capable of delivering large payloads, for example, possibly a nuclear warhead. Now, even though this was in 1987, this also included unmanned aerial vehicles, the UAVs before they were called drones. That's what they were. They weren't hugely popular back then. The technology was still very rudimentary, but they existed and it covered those. So Trump decides to change it, reclassify what the drones we use are so that they're no longer a part of this treaty and they can then be sold. What he's doing, here's what it says. The drones in the category must have a maximum airspeed of less than 800 kilometers per hour, which will allow sales of the Reaper and Predator drones used by the U.S. military, as well as others made by U.S. defense manufacturers. And that is exactly who is going to benefit from this. The White House said, and this is their official statement, not only do these outdated standards give an unfair advantage to countries outside of the MTCR and hurt United States industry, they also hinder our deterrence capability abroad by handicapping our partners and allies with subpar technology. Twice in their decision, they mention industry. That's because that's what this is all about. This is not going to benefit our allies. This is going to hurt the United States, but it is going to help the military-industrial complex, the weapons manufacturers. They are going to reap in billions of dollars in sales because of this decision. And of course, as is always the case, some of the money they get from those sales is going to be funneled to pay for politicians who are going to make things like this happen. That's how that works. That's how that disgusting little cycle perpetuates itself. And that is exactly why Donald Trump did this. He's facing a tough re-election. He needs all the money he can get. And this is going to help put more dollars in his pocket because it's going to help put more dollars in the pocket of the U.S. defense industry. Oh, and at the same time, it's going to put these horrendous weapons in the hands of people who hate the United States as well. And maybe they love the United States, but they hate other countries. You know, like Saudi Arabia. We've seen the abuses they've already carried out with U.S. weapons. We have seen them sell U.S. weapons to the Taliban, and we still sell them more. I guarantee you they're going to be the first ones in line to get their hands on these drones. Mark my words. Once this is finalized, that will be one of the first stories that gets reported. Massive U.S. drone sales to Saudi Arabia, followed shortly by stories about Saudi Arabia using U.S.-built drones to kill civilians in other parts of the world. That will happen if this plan goes through.